I just want to say, you've probably heard the saying, fortunes are made in recessions. Well, I would say precedent comes out of chaos. Right now, for the first time in your history as producers, you have the opportunity to set contractual precedent. Because just as you said, 100% correct, studios really are still figuring, everybody's figuring this out. There isn't contractual precedent. So you know how you're used to having a 50% exhibitor fee, like 50% goes to the theaters? Well, guess what? Now we have this following more like a mobile model or an enterprise model. We've got 30% going to the exhibitors because all this tech comes out of companies that are dealing with mobile and social. So you, right off the top, are finding ways to potentially reduce, you know, your you're off the tops, which brings more money back to your financiers. My colleague, Brian Summer, Brian, where are you at? Raise. So he, so Brian and I, we wind up negotiating a lot of these deals with something called LBEs, which are location-based experiences, which is where you're seeing like the IMAX and others doing that sort of thing. And we also wind up dealing with a lot of the head-mounted devices that are creating stores for the purpose of having exclusive content because they want to drive people to their stores, and some non-exclusive deals as well. But what's amazing is right now, you have all of the leverage because they all need compelling content. So if you create compelling content, you have the ability to set deal terms, which we love, because what that means is we have the ability to go out and set precedent that is content creator favorable, producer favorable. And the reason that matters, and what we keep preaching to the IMAXs and the others, like the anybody that will listen on the exhibitor side, is that the only way that this industry is going to grow the way everyone wants it to is if we have a healthy VR ecosystem, a healthy immersive ecosystem. And the only way that's going to happen is if financiers are infusing money into content. And right now, financiers, as you very well said, are putting a ton of money into tech, a ton of money into VR. But if we want them to be putting that money into content, they need to see a realistic or have a realistic expectation of getting their money back. And those who have been burned in the past in film or been burned in the past in mobile or those spaces, they're hesitant. And so they understand now these waterfalls. So they're looking at it and saying, okay, yeah, you know, I see that you say you're going to go create content and it's going to go be seen by 2 million people and it's going to bring back this much money, but how much is actually going to flow to you? And when you start to look at the little things we can do to shift it by playing the mobile model off the film model, which we'll go into a little bit later, there are ways that you can actually lower your where you need to have your numbers hit in order to be able to return the full investment to the financiers. So just remember that. It's chaotic. You're 100% right, and there's a lot of stuff to figure out. But the beauty of it is you have so much leverage in contract negotiations, and you as the leaders in the producing world need to be creating precedent right now.